might sound a bit cliche, but to achieve something, to excel in your life, you need to start early.
What's your name?
Siddharth.
Siddharth, you don't need to agree with me. You only need to understand what is being said. Sit. Agreement and disagreement come out of your conditioning. I'm not looking for that. I'm asking for your intelligence so that you can understand what is here. Then after understanding, you are free to reject it. After understanding, you are totally free to reject it. Who taught you that one must achieve in life? The very foundation of what you are saying is that life must be achievement. What you are saying is there must be targets and goals, and life is a process of attaining them. Where are your goals coming from? Don't you see the entire process of conditioning that is behind it? Do you see what is being said? What is being said is, there must be a goal, there must be an effort at attaining that goal, and to attain that goal, one must start early. That is the line of argument that is being given. I want you to understand the basis of it. The fundamental assumption is that life is nothing but an achievement, and all achievement, mind you, is in the future. We have been told that life is something that is divided between success and failure. Do you really think this is your own understanding? No. This comes to you from education, from media, from family, from society. Since childhood, you have been guarded. Attain this, attain that, X percentage, Y percentage, clearing the JEE, getting a job. And how has that process proceeded? Through greed and fear. If you attain something, there will be an external reward. If you do not attain it, there would be an external disincentive. So what is happening? A goal is being set from the outside. A reward is coming from the outside. Or a disincentive is coming from the outside. Is there any bit of you in all this? But because it is happening over a long period of time, so you have started thinking in delusion. You have started thinking that these are my goals that I must attain, and to attain them I must prepare. Are these your goals at all? Are these your goals? Those goals are coming as a result of your conditioning. And all conditioning is nothing but lack of understanding. All conditioning is making somebody a slave. So it is like this, that I am a slave and I want to make the slave do a lot of things. So I condition him thoroughly. And I condition him so deeply that he starts believing that what he is doing is his own desire. The slave starts believing that what he is doing is his own desire. Whereas what he is doing is only what he has been programmed to do. It's like a computer starting to believe that it is functioning on its own. No, it's not functioning on its own. It has been programmed to function in a certain way. And then the computer gets up and argues that, well sir, I have certain goals to achieve, certain things to excel in, so I must look towards the future. And the one who has programmed him is standing by and smiling at the success of his programming. we may be living. I just invite you to look at it. I just invite you to look at your own minds and thought processes. How in, every goal is a desire. We understand that? Every goal is a desire. How many of our goals are really ours? How many of our goals are really ours? There would be so many amongst us who are sitting here purely because somebody else wanted them to pursue engineering. There would be so many here who need a particular kind of job purely because somebody else expects them to get that kind of job. There would be so many here who would be pursuing MBA after engineering purely because there are a couple of MBAs in their family. How many of your goals are yours? You can understand that only when you become attentive to the processes of your mind. And when you become attentive to the processes of your mind, all that happens in this moment. And in this moment, you find there are no goals. There are no goals. It's alright. Once you have understood what you are doing, after that, if you want to pursue it with all the rigor and effort and planning, you are most welcome. But firstly, for your own sake, see what you are pursuing. Is it really yours? A 5-year-old kid, it is understandable. He has yet not developed the physical framework, the physical infrastructure in which intelligence can prosper. But you are 18 years, 20 years old. If you claim that you do not understand what is happening with your life, then you must understand. It's high time you understand. Because it's you who has to live your life, not the one who is conditioning you, not the one who is influencing you. You and your intelligence. That's it, nothing.